Hello everybody, and welcome back to part 2 of my Medieval Lords Let's Play. First things, you'll notice that I have a new microphone, which I'll be using for the foreseeable future, as it's much better than the inbuilt laptop microphone. And second of all, I've managed to fix the weird grainy graphics issue. Turns out it was caused by shadowing, which you can easily change by going into the options in the main menu. So previously I had it on all high, it's now on all high, but there's no shadows. So you see, there's no shadows. But there's no grainy effect, so I'd rather have no shadows than broken shadows, so that's a win-win. Anyway, so I'm currently making a lot of money. I have a load of food, but for some reason when you load the game from a previous save, the food takes a while to reset, so if I put the game onto full speed, yeah, see, it's gone down to still loads, but it's not 3,500. It's 707. But that still loads. But I don't have an army, so I might need more food to compensate for a larger army. So let's go ahead and build some food. Also, hopefully the commentary will make more sense, because obviously it won't cut out, and the last video was the first video I've ever recorded, so hopefully I should be a bit better at this now than I was. So he says. Anyway. Put it onto full speed. I have a load of money, and yeah, just make some nice food for everyone. Go to the vineyard. Yeah. Aha, the cows are now back to health. Makes no difference to me, I don't have any cows. And these people have loads and loads of food. So, I'm going to build some soldiers. Build a barracks there. And I can't quite fit another one on this island. Can't fit any. Damn! Nowhere to put a barracks. That's a problem. I'll try to make do with just make do with two barrackses. Can't get a third. Oh no, the Vikings are coming. Good thing we're rich. Ha ha ha. Good thing is that we can't be attacked in our present state, except by the Vikings, but we can just keep paying them off. And hopefully I'll have enough food for these soldiers. Ah, god, the fish! Well, that's shit. So that thing said that the fish are only producing 20% of the food they should be producing. Okay, we're okay for food, but we will need more. Build. No. I was going to say I'd build a witch's house to upgrade these houses, but no, I won't. I will just build. God's sake. Fuck. Okay, build. Build, build corn. Just tiny, tiny field here. And boom! More food. Food for the populace. It's not a very balanced diet if they just eat nothing but corn, but hey, I ain't complaining. Diets in 1015 were weird. apparently. More corn. So basically, people on this island eat fish, corn, fruit, more corn, grapes, wine, more corn, lots of fish, pigs, and hens. And vegetables. So it's actually not a bad diet. But who am I to comment on the diet of a fictional people in a game set 1,000 years ago? Oh wait, I'm the guy playing the game. Anyway, moving on. We should now have enough. Yeah, we now have enough food. Oh dear, workers. Workers are needed. I'm just going to convert. No, I'm not. I was going to convert that to a vegetable garden, but I'm not. Ah, damn. Because I built that house, he's consuming food. What? That's weird. We just got a sudden bump in food. Yeah. I don't know why. Because the vineyards and the orchards give you food in October, and the cornfields give you food in July. So why do we get a load of food in September? Because the hens and the pigs and the fish and the vegetable gardens give you food every month, so I have no idea, but I'm not complaining, we've got a fuckload of food. And we're going to train more soldiers. Should have trained them from there, but oh well. God damn it. I can't put these 50 into those 200 to make a 250. I have to actually create another thing. I really hate these brigands. Because what happens is, they have 520 troops, and they sort of just swarm, like, here, here, and here. So you kind of want to spam them with troops, because if they break through, then they either raid or attack, go for your main dungeon, and both of those are non-ideal situations, because it basically means that you can't win, and I'm pretty sure that to win you have to kill them all and have some troops in this area. So, like, not this area, even though they do technically own it. I can't train any more troops. Must have built another house. You know what? More houses. Damn, I had a space then. Ah, god damn it. House there. House there. Build one there. Let's check water. Water, water everywhere, but not a drop to drink. Typical. Like, you're on an island and you don't have water. Do you really need a well? Like, you could just walk down the road and, oh look, there's some water. Anyway, now I can get another 50 soldiers. Oh! It's rapidly increasing as the houses develop. But sadly it doesn't go to 700. Oh, maybe it does. What do you want? Serenity! Let's give you some serenity. Just hope we have enough food. Ah, fuck off, Vikings. See, we have a load of... We have more than enough to... They could ask for twice what they're asking for, and it probably wouldn't be a problem. They're so stupid. Ask for more. Like, you're not a threat. Anyway. Could do with... I want more food, but there is nowhere to... There's nowhere to build food. Like, unless you can squeeze an orchard in here. Nope. Game's not letting me. Squeeze an orchard in here. Maybe. Yeah. Maybe. Maybe. Oh, oh, oh! No! Fuck you, game. Maybe in here. Yes. Oh. Yep. Ah. Nope. Can't get anything there. And I can't even fit a... I can't fit a vegetable garden in there. I can't fit anything in there. What a load of bullshit. Right. Can we fit anything here? Yes, we can. And a vineyard. Yep, I'm liking... Yep, oh yes. And maybe fit in something here? Yes. Yep. You do end up with some very, very odd-shaped fields in this game. I mean, that's pretty normal. But I've had fields in this game literally go in on themselves. So, like, it'd be like here, 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 and then back to here, and then back to here. So, like a very weird... triangular Pac-Man type shape. I don't know how to describe it. If you've played this game before, you probably know what I mean. And if you haven't, well, just triangular Pac-Man, I guess. It's really about maximizing use of the land, just to because you really want nowhere to be wasted. It's like, see here, you might think, why are you building fields everywhere? But I've already got a load more food. And if I just build another house, I can get up to 700 troops. Really, it's 600 because I've got 100 in that main dungeon. Ah, goddammit. There we go. Alright. Water? You've got water. Boom. And another lot of troops. And build the bridge. Actually, you know what? Let's save. Oh yeah, a downside about this game, other than the fact you can't change the controls, which link to the fact you can't change the controls, the quick save button is F9. If you use fraps to record, like I'm doing, the default record button is F9, so every time you start and stop recording, you quick save. So the only way I can really save is manually saving rather than quick save. But to be honest, that's not a massive problem because that's how I save anyway. So yeah, that's not a massive problem. Anyway, this bridge is now built. Right, I now have... I've now got troops. 700 troops. You might think move these over here, but I think that's a bad idea, because, I mean, you want backup troops. We have enough food, we have enough money. We're doing okay. Just save it again, just to be cautious. Right, let's deploy and hope for the... Yeah, you see, we can't deploy that close. Yeah, there. And another one. There. Hopefully, can we build a road? No, we can't. Can we build? No, we can't. Yeah, because it's enemy territory, the only thing I can do is deploy soldiers. I can't build a tower or a dungeon. I can only build troops. Can't build a barracks. Actually, that frees up some space. Now, do I go with food or... I'm thinking houses. And a vegetable patch. Right. The fight will begin when that countdown ends. It's five... Shit, hang on. Why have we got 550? Oh, god damn it. These guys never made it in time. Fuck. And... Because I built those houses, we can now get another 50. So currently it's 550 against 520. See? They just kind of go around you. They're actually quite intelligent in that respect. But I think if these guys stay here and they survive... then we win. So, these guys are going to come over here. And whether they raid or go for the main dungeon, I'm not sure. This hasn't gone to plan, if I'm honest. Looks like they're going for the main dungeon. But they won't succeed. If they do, then... if they do succeed, I will literally... Oh, fuck. There we go! Scared then, because 20 dies very instantly, but... right, we don't need them. Put them in there. And disband the other troops that we don't need. Contemplating keeping them. I'll keep them for now. We can afford them. More than afford them, really. And... oh. We've got these guys. So that was easy. These guys only have 400 troops, so they're fairly easy to take down. They might be a fiefdom. If they're a fiefdom, that means that rather than... like it was with these guys, you can't just destroy their main dungeon and then you win. You have to destroy their main dungeon and then... defend their main dungeon while they do a counter-attack. And if you beat their counter-attack, then you win. Normally with fiefdoms, the counter-attack is quite actually... I mean, you can't control your troops, they can't really control theirs, but they kind of all come from one place. And... I just realised this isn't a fiefdom, so this won't apply. This will apply in the Fernsey Isles one, which is the next level. Where, like, the final boss, as it were, is to destroy a fiefdom. So that'll make more sense when I do that. Speak of the devil. They've decided to attack me, so move these guys to here. And put you guys in these towers. They're going for the main dungeon, but I think they'll probably just raid. They'll do either or, I'm not sure which. Just put these guys in towers temporarily. You can see we still have loads of food, even with all these soldiers. We still have enough room for 280 more, so it'll go up to 750 unless some of them die, which they will. Now, yeah, you see, they're just raiding. What this means is they basically, they just destroy houses. It's just a pain because, like, I can just repair. But now these houses don't belong to me for a while. It says booty from raids. That means that I don't own them. Not the end of the world because they only provide a bit of gold. It's only 4 houses out of everything we own. They're not even developed, really. Why are they level? Oh, now we own them, so it's only temporary. Just wait for the area to stabilize. More Vikings. Good thing we have 102,000 gold and they only want 5. Sorry. Anyway, holding control means that you can select more than one set of soldiers at a time. So that's 250 there. And 200 here. I'm just putting them here now temporarily, because obviously we're going to assault these guys. Save the game. There's a problem with the sheep, but doesn't affect me. I don't have any sheep, so I've actually been really lucky with the disasters this game. It's always just been things that I don't... Oh, God. It's always just been things that I don't have, and I've just noticed that we need more food. Those extra 200 that I just trained have taken a toll on our food supply. That's an annoying thing about this game, is that troops require a lot of food. Having enough money in this game isn't that big of a problem. Although it is later on, because in the later missions you notice things like cavalry increases serenity, but there's no maintenance. And then later on you get a wooden chapel costs 80 in maintenance, and like a church is 250. And eventually it's a, like, the more developed a house is, the more tax you get out of it. But the more expensive buildings cost more to maintain. And you need them to get the high developed houses. So you're never really in a situation where you're making a fortune. Like, this is a lot. It's just gone up for... I was going to say, it went from 790 to 865, now it's back down to 790. I don't know why. But yeah, we need more food, and we don't have any room. Oh, wait! Ha! I was going to say, we don't have any room for food, but... Save it again. You'll come to realise that I do like saving games. I save a lot. But now that these bandits are crushed, we can actually build. Here. So, if I build sort of like a little hexagon, I can build a dungeon! Oh yeah! Look at that! So, sort my troops out. I've got 550 there. These guys can merge with the... Okay. Merging in this game is a bit weird. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Anyway, if I put some houses down, see, this territory now belongs to me. And that will as well once I finish with it. Okay, first things first. Fish. Fish. There will be other fish. Okay, they're attacking me again. Good thing we have troops stationed in the area. I'm not worried. And I think that's all the fish. Yeah, they need workers. And these guys need water. Build some wells. Speed this along. And, oh, god damn it. Ah, fuck off. You have to fucking raid that shit. Ugh. Rather than going to my troops, they actually decided to do the sensible thing and, raid. Anyway, we need, repair that. Vegetable gardens. Sheep have made a full recovery, makes no difference to me. Vegetable gardens everywhere, and I think that's enough. Like, we can't build any more. Oh, I just realised. I forgot to build one of these. This is a farm work... that's not ideal. This is a farm workshop. It increases grain production in local areas. So... requires a blacksmith to build, but we have a blacksmith. So, build one here. This field and this field now produce more corn. So, as if you didn't have already enough corn, you've now got more corn. Because apparently peasants eat nothing but corn. They do cost a bit to maintain, 100 gold, but I think we've got enough. And now we have quite a lot of food. And we're making even more. So, let's attack these guys. And then we can disband the troops that we don't need anymore. We should win, because they don't have that many troops. See, they've got a decent base. I'm not sure if it would work if I built it. Do they have enough food to supply the troops? They do have a hunting lodge, which... if there's... they're harder to see than fish, but if there's like deer or something nearby, you build one of these nearby and it just gives you food. But you can only build it when there's deer nearby, in the same way that's like fish. And bring up the rest of the troops. And we should win. Making lots of money, lots of food. Build more cornfields, because who doesn't love a good corn field? These guys just love their corn. They can't get enough. But it won't work a field if it's too big. Figure that out. So they love their corn, but they don't work if the field's too big. Yes, see? We won. That's how you do it. And improve this, even though we don't really need to, but just do it anyway. And I think... well, upgrade that to the wooden dungeon. See, this new wall system is because we have the mason, which we can't build, so... if this gets destroyed, we don't have a mason and we can't build another one, but fortunately we can just repair it. Convert this to vegetable garden. Convert this to a flower garden. That provides serenity. These guys want serenity. And now we're making a ton of food because we don't have to pay for any soldiers. And also because of this. I can't really call this a base. I can't really call it a village. It's just... it's literally there to give me a bit of money and a load of food. Okay. Save the game again. A lot can go wrong in this game. I did say at the start, if the main dungeon dies, then you lose the game. So it's vital that you save... when you're preparing for the inevitable or an attack or just something big. Downside is that suppose the corn failed now and I lost a load of food. If I saved and reloaded, the corn would still fail. I think even though it's random every time you play the game, I think it's kind of predetermined. So, or it might not be, and what I just said is a load of bullshit. I don't know. It wouldn't surprise me, because this game, there's a lot of bullshit in this game. Anyway, since we have a lot of food, and we will need to, let's build some soldiers here. Three barracks, and, there you go. We can build a hunter's lodge here, which provides even more food. And I think there was some fish around here. More Vikings. If you want 5,500 gold, take it. Ah. Okay. Fishermen, not doing well. 20% normal. And I think that's all the fish. Can't see any more. Oh. They require a storage building. So I'm going to expand out over here. And I might have to build a barn, but I'm hoping that the catchment area of this village might just sort of transport food over. No, they do need a food storage. Okay, I'm going to build a barn. Oh, no, that's fine. They have food storage. Orchard. Yeah. See, that's kind of what I meant by the triangular Pac-Man, except if you imagine that this kind of goes out even further to literally here. It's physically impossible, but in this game, it's allowed. Don't ask why. Anyway, more vineyards, because you can never have too much food. And also, we're gonna need it for the army later. You might be thinking, army? What army? I don't see any enemies on this map. Well, what happens is I'm going to need to build a bridge from here to here. I'll probably build another one from here to here. And is it physically possible? Good thing that now that we have a mason, we can build a stone bridge. And the stone bridges are more expensive, but they have infinite range. So you see... Oh. Tell a lie, they don't have infinite range. But they have a much greater range than the wooden bridge. And, like, you can't build a wooden bridge from this island to this island. But you can build a stone bridge. So, I'm going to go ahead and build a stone bridge. And save it again, because, I'm a saveaholic. I save all the time. Save my games all the time. And this is the lighthouse. You have access to the lighthouse's foundations. Now you need to acquire enough gold to start work and recruit inhabitants to build the lighthouse. The more workers you have, the faster the lighthouse will be built. That makes sense. The only downside to this is that this lighthouse takes a frickin' long time to repair. And also, for whatever reason, the Vikings don't like the idea of me having a lighthouse. So, as I try to repair it, the Vikings will try and stop me. And they kind of come in waves, so like they don't just continuously attack. So there is kind of like a cooldown period between attacks. But I don't think they come to attack until you start repairing the lighthouse. You also kind of want to build up a base there as well, so build up lots of soldiers. And we're going to need a lot of food for these soldiers. So we have a lot of food already, but that's going to go very quickly once I build up a base around that lighthouse. And the soldiers, as I've mentioned many times. In case you haven't caught on, soldiers require a lot of food in this game. Okay. In fact, you know what? We don't need that. It's just a waste of money. And we don't need that either. Catapults and ballista, and later on trebuchets, but we need a mechanic for a trebuchet, which we can actually build. That's interesting. So, if I get some level 6 houses, I can build a mechanic, and that'll be useful, because then I can get trebuchets. So what do you want? You want health. Build a doctor. There's no room. Okay. Can we build it? No. What do you want? You all want health. And you want serenity. So let's build a wooden chapel. Convert this to vegetable garden. They want health. So yeah, the doctor. That affects the whole place, so it should make a difference. Goes from 25 to. Oh. Okay. Well, it's affected these guys. But now they need more serenity. So. Build a flower. No. Build a stone statue. Yeah, stone statue. It's expensive, but we do have a lot of money. And now they need more security. So, I could station troops here, but that's expensive. So I'm just going to build a gallows, and that will reduce the serenity, but hopefully not by enough that they complain. Oh, goddammit, now they need more health. There's always something wrong with these guys. Well, more Vikings. Send them in. I don't care. Build a witch's house, and hopefully. Yeah, there we go. Oh. Okay, those guys want security, those guys want health. Oh. Build another witch's house then. So health is fine, now they just want security. Build another gallows. Hang on. Yeah, another gallows. Okay. Can we build a mechanic? Yeah, yes, yes, yes. Right, put the mechanic down here. Why not? Doesn't really matter where you build it. As long as it's got workers, which it does. And the mechanic allows us to build trebuchets, which will be useful for fending off the Vikings. Doesn't allow any dungeons or walls or towers. Doesn't allow any of these, but it does allow a public park, which increases faith or serenity. It's quite big, so we don't really have enough room to build it. It does allow bear trainers, jousting fields for leisure. It doesn't allow anything for health. No new food things. Nope, no new food things. Oh. You get a water mill. I forgot about that. That's very similar to this thing, except it works on the coast. So this is going to affect these two grain fields. Might affect that, I'm not sure. It's not the whole thing. But if we build another one there, that's a lot of food. But now we need more money. Damn it. Well, they still need a storage building. Okay. So we need more money. Let's just build some houses. put these troops here temporarily. We should have enough food, but if we don't, we've got more than enough space to build some more farms. Yeah, we've got loads of food. So he says. See, it's drastically decreasing. For some reason, you have to pay upkeep on troops in barracks, but you don't have to pay them food. Yeah, I'm gonna... No, we're now making... Yeah, we're now making a lot more money. But we will need a lot more food, so... Can I fit a few vegetable patches in here? I can fit one there. One there. There. Anywhere will do, as long as it's... I will build a vegetable patch anywhere you let me, game. Just as long as you let me. There. There. And I think that'll do. I mean, we will need more food later on. Build a well. I'm going to need a barn because this is complaining too much. Yeah, we've got loads of gold. But what I'm going to do is build more corn for food. Oh. And a vineyard. Another vineyard.